were there, bring the meeting to a start. Welcome, it's the January 2016, first forum of the year. So welcome, and thanks for coming out on a chilly evening in January. This is going to be my last forum as chair. I'll be standing down at the AGM at the end of the month, and I'll be concentrating on the neighbourhood plan, to get that into action. So we have an AGM on the 1st of February, 6:30 at the schoolhouse. That's 6:30 at the schoolhouse, 1st of February. It's open to everyone, so if you want to come along just to see what's happening, come along. We'll also be planning how the next year of the forum will look with the meetings and stuff, so okay for that. If you know anyone who might be interested in a position, come along. Linda Neiman, she's also going to be standing down as treasurer, so she's going to be coming with me to oversee part of the working group to get the neighbourhood plan going. Thank Linda for all her hard work at the forum. Both of us are here from the start and found part of the founding members, and she's put a lot of time and effort, and so I'd like to thank her. On that note, I think it's probably good to look at what we've done over the last year. It's been quite a busy year. We initiated after 2014 in November, we started talking about barrier busting, and we've got council support with that now. We've drafted up a number of measures. Barrier busting is a way of community debt. It cuts through red tape of bringing legislation, and it's to do with problems with housing, supported housing that we have. You know that the MP Tobias Elwood has been working on a separate set of measures that he's going to try and introduce as a private member's bill. But we are also coming forward with some ideas and some things looking for a support. First support locally through other forums, and now I think we're at the point where we're going to approach other councils to see if they can support us. And we might see within the next 6 months this becoming a law that we can use to tackle some of the problems that we haven't had the law available to us to tackle locally. So I think that's a really good success. We've also initiated the neighbourhood plan. Currently we have a constitution, which is a hard work. But we have a very good constitution. So we've got a working group and a temporary set of officers in the working group. And we're just about to submit the next meeting on the 23rd, and we'll be submitting our constitution and the areas, designated areas of the local planning authority, who will then hopefully approve it. We'll come back with minor adjustments. And then we can apply for our funding. So we should be looking at having our first AGM, where we will elect some permanent officials, probably about March, April. And it's a really exciting piece of localism, and it will produce a planning document, a big thick document, which will say what can and can't be built in Boscombe. And it will allow everyone in Boscombe to take part and feed into that process so that we can decide what we want to see in our area. So it's a really fantastic piece of exercise to take place, because it will not only bring everyone out of their houses and engaging into that process, but we'll actually start seeing things in our areas that we want. Because quite often, I mean, there was a building just across the road where there was all sorts of shenanigans last year with stuff, and they went to appeal and got it approved. And quite often this is what happens. People in the area don't want to see something built, but you know, even if our planning authority says they don't want it as well, they just go to appeal and we get it anyway. So a neighbourhood plan is a much stronger piece of law, planning law, in the last 5 to 10 years. And it will also generate an income for the community, because we will get percentage of the building levy. So I encourage everybody, when the time comes, to come get involved with that. And we have an email, npboscombe@gmail.com. So if you're interested, that's npboscombe@gmail.com. If you're interested in getting involved or getting on mailing list, send us an email or see if I'm going to start to this. We've had a number of forums. Well, one of them we did the local elections, but we possibly have the most amount of candidates out of the whole of Bournemouth and Paul. And probably anywhere else in the country. And it was pretty successful, I think. And we had a good turnout, good section of the candidates, most of them turned up. And we got a lot of comments saying that it was informative and helpful in helping people make their decisions. So I thought that was very good. We've tackled a wide variety of subjects, health, pressing matters. We did one last year on shared space, which was a very good meeting. We've tackled hundreds of action points and got questions and answers over the last 3 years, which has been very good. We've got a communications framework being set up with the council. We've got a much better relationship now, getting much better information coming through, which helps us put our meetings together. So we're on a much, much better footing than when we first started. We were pretty much going by what the Echo printed, which is not always 100% reliable. We've also, in the process of putting a local economic development plan, we're working with Bournemouth 2026. It was a DCLG project. If you want to start basis, put your name on.
Yeah, the Community Economic Development Plan is, I'll update it by Boston Forum Secretary. So it's a community-led plan, so again, part of localism, to look at what industries locally we can sort of help and assist. There's a small pot of money which goes to investigating, talking to community, talking to local business and seeing what can be developed in those terms. So we're looking around the creative and arts industries in Boston. And we did a consultation for Christmas to assist us with the draft plan, so that's now been sent off for confirmation that we're on the right direction with good intent. And now, come to January, we'll be doing some more consultations and finalising that plan, I think, by April. That should give us quite a nice something to hold to and work on the future of Boston's economy. So, watch the space, I think, where we publish much of that stuff. I don't know, it'll go on there soon.
We'll put something on the forum website about that as well. I think that'll be quite helpful with the neighbourhood plan as well, to have an economic plan for the area that should help some of what we're trying to achieve, because that was overall idea. We had a good visit to Avonbourne to look at some of the great stuff that Teach First has done there as well. I mean, teachers doing some fabulous stuff, and hopefully we'll be having her here in March to talk more about what she's doing. She's maybe able to try to get her here in November, but unfortunately she couldn't make that one. We'll be holding a special meeting and other hustings for the Crime Commissioner in April. So we'll give you a date for that once we finalise it. So, all in all, I think we've had a very, very good year as the forum. It's on a very short footing, always a bit short of cash, but maybe we've kind of got by. I think the futures of the forum are not quite sure where it goes. I think that's when the neighbourhood plan has actually got a plan. That will be a very representative group for Boscombe, and that these two entities may merge. Part of the thing at the moment, one standing down, is that I think there needs to be a distinction between the two, the forum and the neighbourhood plan. The neighbourhood plan needs to concentrate on just doing what it does. So eventually, once it has a plan, I think it would be a representative body that will be handling money. It will be a community owned thing. So we'll see how that develops over the years. It's going to take a couple of years to get it get it all done. But it'll be an interesting process. Okay, tonight we've got two speakers. We've got Catherine Mellon, who's going to bring us up to speak with the indices of deprivation, which is the statistics that have just come out late last year, and she'll be pulling out the relevant statistics, but also giving us updates to bring them up to speed, because they, even though they've come out this last year, they're a bit older than that. They're based on census figures, about 5 years old. So she can bring us up to speed, so we can see where things are getting better and where things haven't really changed or they're getting worse. And after that, we've got the leader of the council, John Beasley, who's going to give us a short presentation, an overview of what the council are doing, and then we'll be taking questions. We've had some submitted in advance from people, and we'll be taking questions on the floor. What I'll do is I'll alternate between the questions we've submitted and questions from the floor, just to keep an eye.